any further ado, it's my pleasure this morning to welcome our speaker, the Honorable Mayor Randall Woodfin. Mayor Woodfin.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
To all the mothers in the place with style and grace, happy Mother's Day. To the graduates, my summa cum laude, magna cum laude, cum laude, and my favorite, thank you, laude. Good morning to y'all. It's truly an honor to be here with you to celebrate this great milestone in each of your lives. Because this is your day, I promise I'll try to keep it short. I must first start by thanking Dr. Perry Ward for extending me the invitation to speak with you all this morning. I also want to thank the hardworking faculty and staff you all saw march in with the students that pour so much into the product you have today. As mayor, you make my job easy by educating the future business and civic leaders of today and tomorrow, and I'm truly grateful for the work you put in every single day. Now, I got to do a roll call right quick because there are a lot of people in this room. So where are all my proud mothers and fathers? And what about the siblings and aunts and uncles? What about my grandparents? First and second and third cousins?
Decided to tear down his barns to build larger ones.
that we're able to store all of this grains as well as goods. And the rich man went to then say to himself, and I quote, "You have ample goods laid up for many years, so just relax, eat, drink, and be merry." But God proceeded to call this rich man. Now, if he had called our grandparents, he probably would have sent it through the mail. If it was my parents, God probably would have made a phone call. If it was directly to me, it probably would have been a text message. And to a lot of our graduates out here, it probably would have been a DM. But that direct message, that text, that phone call, that letter in the mail would have said one word. Fool. And God then asked the rich man, "All the things that you have prepared, whose will they belong to when your soul is required of you?" See, there are many reasons why this rich man can be considered a fool. But for now, I will highlight the reasons that are most relevant to you in this moment in your life. First, I believe the rich man was a fool because he failed to acknowledge anyone besides himself when addressing this accomplishment. Now think about that for a second. Have any of you worked on the phone? I can tell you I haven't. But I imagine that it's hard, hard work. Now think about it again. This rich man grew so much grain that he couldn't even store it in his barns. He actually had to build more barns, larger barns, just to store it. Now ask yourself this, brothers. Who helped him plant the seeds? I know he didn't plant it all by himself. Who helped him pick the grain? Who helped him build the additional barns? And who helped him buy the tools? See, there's nothing that makes me more angry than hearing folks refer to themselves as self-made. Or hearing folks talk about pull yourself up by your own bootstraps. Sure, go ahead and pull yourself up. But please don't forget that someone gave you those boots. Don't forget that someone gave you those straps. Today you will receive a degree that bears your name. However, I hope you understand that you do not make it here on your own. Someone, somebody, some family member prayed for you. Someone encouraged you along the way. Someone studied with you out of class. I see way too many excited family members in this room to believe you earned this degree by yourself. See, my college degree continues to hang in my office. It has my name or my college on it. It has my major on it. But what it doesn't have is my mother's name, Cynthia Woodfin. And I can tell you as a mother, with more than one child, she sacrificed everything she had and didn't have just to ensure that I had a shot to achieve my goals. My degree does not have my big brother's name on it, Ralph Woodfin. Murdered years ago, his impact on my life helped make me the man I am today. My degree does not have the names of my host of aunts, uncles, cousins, and church mothers that molded me into the leader I am today. So yes, graduates, and I'm looking at each of you. Today is your moment, but this moment is much bigger than you. And the rich man did not understand that. And because this moment is bigger than you, I believe the rich man was also considered a fool because he was selfish with his gifts. Each of you as you walk across this stage this morning will be armed with an additional gift. But rather than the rich man share his grains that he harvested, he decided to build bigger barns to store his goods. Again, he had rather relaxed, eat, drink, and be merry by himself. I gotta tell y'all something. Today in our country, we don't need bigger bars. Our community needs brothers and sisters who are willing to share their gifts and blessings to improve upon the lives of others. If you think that your life is the only life that will be impacted by the degree you receive today, somebody told you wrong. This country needs your gifts. Birmingham needs your talents. We need your next big ideas. Graduates, we need your next small business. Whether you know it or not, there is someone out here in this audience. There is someone out here in this community that is waiting to be inspired by you. There is someone that needs to see you as an example of what happens when you stay focused and you refuse to give up. Until we have eliminated discrimination and poverty. Until every child in Birmingham public schools can read at their own grade level. You don't have the time to be married, to sit around and eat and drink only. You have to use the talents and the gift you've learned with today to help this community. So here's what I want to say before I take my seat. I thank all of us in this room who are surrounding you, who are your cheerleaders, who are sitting here in support of you, realize you've come a long way. And we celebrate. But you still have hard work to do and loads to lift. Truthfully, even us on this stage, we still have work to do. But collectively, with you all taking the lead, graduates, our time is now. And we can't wait. Because the city of Birmingham needs you. The state of Alabama needs you. The entire South needs you. And this country needs your talents. I'm convinced that we're making this country the best version of itself. It starts with graduates who are sitting in this room. We will take your talents and figure out a way to improve everyone's lives that you touch. There's a song that's going to be played after I take my seat. I encourage you all to embrace the words of it. While in Texas yesterday, the whole theme of the commencement speakers were marks. Or a phrase that Nike uses all the time, just do it. But here I am telling you all, once you exit this stage, armed with your additional talent, armed with your degree, just do it. Do what it takes to make your life, your family's life, and the community around you, those who feel like having a positive impact on, work. Thank you, and God bless.